What's up, you guys? Nicolo Maserati here. Today, we are going to be talking about how to create a countdown timer using expressions in Adobe After Effects. Now, don't be intimidated if this is your first time ever using expressions. This is really easy. And whether you want to create a 5-minute timer like this, or a 2-minute timer like this, or an even shorter timer, we're going to be learning how to do that in After Effects. But before we get into it, let's run that intro. All right, guys, so like I said, today we're gonna be learning how to create a countdown timer in After Effects using expressions. But before we get into all that, if you enjoy this kind of content and you wanna see more, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell so you can be notified every single time I upload a new video. All right, guys, let's just jump into After Effects. All right, guys, as you can see, we are in Adobe After Effects right now, and I haven't created a composition yet, so that's the first thing that we're gonna do. We're just gonna go up here to composition, and we're gonna create a new composition. From here, I'm just gonna name it countdown timer, and I'm gonna set it to 1920 by 1080. Frame rate's gonna be 24. I'm actually gonna change that to 23.976. And then we're gonna do 5-minute duration, or whatever the duration is of the timer that you'd like to use. So for example, if you wanted to do a 2-minute timer, you would change that 5 to 2, or whatever you want. For now, we're gonna keep it at 5, but I'm gonna be showing you guys how to do a 2-minute timer and a 60-second timer as well. So from there, you just wanna go ahead and click okay. And we're gonna have our new composition here. So from here, you wanna right click in this area, go to new, and down to text. Then you want to go to this arrow to expand the text properties, and then expand the text even more, and you'll see this little stopwatch. What you want to do is you want to hold down Alt or Option if you're on a Mac, and click this source text. From there, you're going to paste in this expression code that I'm going to leave in the description of this video, and you just hit Control V and that will paste it. I'm going to expand this so we can kind of see everything that's going on here. So this number you see right here is the amount of seconds. So you can't put minutes, you have to convert the minutes into seconds. So for example, 5 minutes equals 300 seconds, and we've got our 5-minute timer there. Now from here, you can change it to whatever font you want. It really doesn't matter. Let's say you wanted to do 2 minutes. Well, we can get rid of that 300 and type in 120. That's 120 seconds in 2 minutes, and now it's gonna be a 2-minute timer. Now let's say, for example, you wanted to create a 60-second timer. If we were to change this to 60, it would be 1 minute, and then from there, it would have the 0 in front of it and the rest of the time that's gonna be left. Let's say you didn't want that 0 there and you just wanted it to start from 60 seconds. Well, what you do is you go down to where it says C.substring and change this 4 to 6. And once you do that, it's gonna create a 2-digit number instead of a 4-digit number. It's really that simple. All right, you guys, let's get back to my face. All right, guys, so that is it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got something from it. See, using expressions isn't that hard. It's actually pretty easy. So if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe, and I'd love to hear what you think of this video in the comments. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next video.